Newton's rings. The phenomenon of Newton's rings, named after Isaac Newton, is an interference pattern caused by the reflection of light between two surfaces, a spherical surface and an adjacent flat surface. When a parallel beam of monochromatic light is incident, normally on a combination of a planar convex lens and a glass plate, a part of each incident ray is reflected from the lower surface of the lens and a part, after refraction through the air film between the lens and the plate, is reflected back from the plane surface. These two reflected rays are coherent, hence they will interfere and produce a system of alternate dark and bright rings. Apparatus: monochromatic light, wooden mount. This is a rectangular shaped box at the bottom of which we place plain glass, material and the lens. Light is directed to the lens through this reflector. Optically flat glass plate, a planar convex lens, traveling microscope. Procedure: turn on the sodium lamp. Place a planar convex lens on the plain glass plate with curved surface in contact with the glass plate and place the system inside a mount placed under a traveling microscope. The reflector on the mount will direct light onto the optical system. Focus the traveling microscope to see the bright and dark circular fringes. Fix a vertical crosswire of the microscope on the 20th bright ring at leftmost end and record the reading on the horizontal scale. Repeat these measurements for microscope movement from left to right and evaluate the diameters of different rings. Calculations: the main scale has 20 divisions in between 2 cm readings and the vernier scale has 50 total divisions. So the least count of microscope is 1 by 20 divided by 50 is equal to 0.001. Take the reading of main scale just before the 0th position of vernier scale. Only one line of the vernier scale will coincide with the main scale. Take the reading of that point from vernier scale. So the reading can be calculated as main scale reading plus the product of vernier scale reading and least count.